Bobbing in the golden sunset on Awarua Harbour, sheltered by Rarotonga's jagged peaks, the Marumaruatua sits as an impressive sight. Its double hulls, engraved compass, wooden beams and double mast, the Vaka Moana is in the care of the Cook Islands Voyaging Society. Its spokesman is Alex Teariki-Ola.
This Vaka and the other sister canoes, identically designed and built, were replicas of another canoe that was built by the Cook Islands about 30 years ago now. That was called Te Awotonga. Vaka Te Awotonga is now under restoration in the island of Aitutaki. Interestingly, the design for Vaka Te Awotonga came from the notebook of Captain Cook's assistant from the Royal Library in England. So the lines, measurements, everything are absolutely correct down to the last detail, except for the updated modern materials. But our excuse for that is that if our ancestors had these materials, they would be using them.
And on Friday, the Vaka set off on its greatest voyage yet, a tour of all 15 Cook Islands, nearly 2 million square kilometres of ocean, from Rarotonga to Aitutaki, up to Tongariro, down to Mangaia, and every island in between.
On this voyage, as our overall focus is always, it's about teaching and maintaining the way that we sail these canoes in a traditional manner, using traditional techniques, and passing that on to the youth that we're taking with us. We have been to many of our different islands individually, but to do a trip like this, to go to all of them one by one as part of one big trip is incredible. It's very historic, it's awesome.
And they're doing it old school, the traditional way. No aids, no electronics. Just two master navigators, the stars, the wind and the currents. Dion Wong is one of the crew.
What the captain will do is turn off all of our electrical equipment, obviously keep the radio on, so he takes the watches off us, our phones, any devices, and then so we'll be guided if we're leaving during the day, you know, by the swells, the sun, really the sun on the rising and the setting. And then once the sun goes down, oh man, you've got the sky, so you're using all the stars.
Marumaruatua is not big. End to end, it takes about 10 paces. But the 16 crew will be crammed into the hulls for as long as it takes. Estimated to be about 4 months. But there's a saying, the Vaka arrives when she wants to.
So this is our steering helm, basically, or our oi. So there's someone on this 24/7. The new guys usually get these front ones because that's where you get the most smashing and the rocking, and or if you're playing up, you get to come up here and then you get bounced out of your bed sometimes. So this is the deckhouse or the are. The brains are the operations, and also most importantly is the galley. So, you know, that's where all the kai comes out of. Yeah, so we got all the Robert Harris coffees and all of that kind of, the plungers. So the boys, you know, they might look a bit rugged, but yeah, don't mind a bit of latte or those other flash coffees.
It's a voyage about the environment, the ocean, and preserving a threatened tradition. One that saw Te Puna navigate across the Great Moana. A way of life that Alex Teariki-Ola says has become endangered. That's why they're taking a dozen young Cook Islanders, a group of teens who'll learn from the master navigators. Tiana Haxton is one of them.
This is an incredible part of our history, of our culture that was lost and only now has just been managed to come back alive. And it's definitely important for our young ones to get into that and make sure that we don't lose it again.
It was seeing the Vaka pull up at her home island growing up that got her interested. She's hoping her island hopping tour will do the same for other young Kukiairani.
So my first voyage was last year. I went to the island of Mangaia, which is our southernmost island, and it was incredible. Like I know a lot of people think it's a bit daunting being out in the middle of the ocean and seeing no land around you whatsoever. I just absolutely loved it. It's just really freeing, even though I got seasick.
Yeah, Dan was saying you're violently seasick, and you still want to go on this big one.
I have to. It's so cool. Like, it's totally worth it.
Tiana Haxton sees it as something of an obligation.
We only have two master navigators in our entire country, and forgive me for saying, but they will be getting on a bit soon, so we do need our youth to step up and learn. It takes them years to learn and get to the rank of a master navigator. Our youth really does need to get on board and make sure that we don't lose it again.
The crew's been training for weeks, prepping their mama for the voyage, sanding the decks, prepping the kai, stocking up on motion sickness meds. The departure was delayed by the need to get COVID vaccines, but with that done, now they're off into the blue Pacific.